Is frontalis sling my last option to correct ptosis? Hello. I was born with congenital ptosis, and I've had multiple surgeries to correct them. In the last surgery I had, the doctor performed maximal resection of both levator muscles. My eyes still look droopy. He said the only other option is the frontalis sling method, where he'd take tendon from my leg and it would leave a scar. Is this my only option?
Thank you for your question. You submitted a single photo and you limited to just your eyes, and you state, you're asking, is frontalis sling your last option? And you state that you've had congenital ptosis, having undergone multiple surgeries, that your most recent surgery performed was a maximal levator resection. And you feel like your eyelids are still drooping, and your surgeon suggested possibly considering a frontalis sling. And so you want to, of course, know if this is the best option or if this is a good choice. Well, I can certainly share with you my experience and opinion about this type of scenario. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I have performed a lot of surgery for congenital ptosis and in a full range of ages. So I can just share with you first the way I educate my patients about the causes of congenital ptosis and how it impacts on how the correction is performed. So to begin with, you probably already are familiar in that you understand that congenital ptosis is due to a developmental limitation in the muscle that lifts the eyelid, called the levator muscle. This muscle neither contracts fully, as a normal muscle would, nor does it relax fully. And so the goal of any ptosis operation is to first measure and evaluate the degree of strength of that muscle and in prior to doing the surgery, as well as different parameters relative to the height of the eyelid, relative to the pupil, the eye's ability to protect itself from exposure. There's a whole constellation. Now, your doctor determined that you would benefit from what's called a maximal levator resection, which means that the muscle is probably fairly weak and the lid level was relatively low. In maximally shortening that muscle, the lid level was brought to a certain height. Now, the challenge, especially when we're doing this type of procedure on adults, is that the eyelid still has to close properly in order to protect the integrity of the eye. And so even if the eyelid height during surgery is lifted as high as is achievable and is able to be set higher, even overcorrected slightly, there is always an equilibrium. And this applies to both levator resection and a frontalis sling, and I'll explain further about that. But ultimately, what our goal is to have the eyelid open enough so that when you are in a normal social setting, the eyelid height clears the pupil, that you have good vision, relatively good symmetry, and you are able to close your eyes. Now, even when the eyelid is elevated beyond what is the usual, the body protects the eye, and so people naturally start to squeeze in order to blink and lubricate the eye. I have seen in situations where an adult and someone, let's say in their like late 50s or mid 50s, who never got their ptosis corrected, and then they get it done at that stage of life, 1 or 2 millimeters can make the difference between exposure, irritation, and tearing, and comfort. So that's one major factor that you need to consider. Also, understanding that the protective mechanism is necessary. Now, beyond that, there is always a certain amount of equilibrium that's ultimately achieved, because although the lid is lifted, whether it's with the levator muscle or with the frontalis sling, the eyelid continues to close every time you blink, and sometimes you have to force blink. And people who have congenital ptosis will often, after surgery, have a little bit of gaping or opening of the eyelid when they sleep because of the baseline tension. And as I said earlier, the muscle doesn't fully relax. So you have to be careful about lubrication. Now, as far as frontalis sling is concerned, yes, that is an option. And in frontalis sling surgery, especially with adults, the same issues remain. You cannot overcorrect to the point where the eye is exposed and is going to become dry. Interestingly, children under 6 years old, can tolerate the eyes to be really, really open a lot better than adults, most likely because of the ability to liberally lubricate the eye, as well as just the way the eye is able to protect itself. But there's kind of a natural adaptation that occurs when you do these types of surgeries in children, where you can really lift that eyelid very high and they won't have exposure. Their eyes may be wide open when they sleep, and certainly that can be a little bit unsettling for the parents, but they don't tend to have the dry eye issues that adults do. So I think that you have to make this decision based on how much more you're willing to tolerate. You know, when I look at your photo and I look at your eyes, I would say that you have a reasonable outcome. That although it may not be as high as you like, you've achieved a reasonable degree of symmetry and a reasonable amount of height. And one of the golden rules of aesthetic surgery is that the enemy of a great result is a perfect result. You may find yourself regretting if your eyelid is forced a little bit higher and then you deal with eye exposure. So yes, your doctor, I'm sure, wants to do the best job possible for you. But at the same time, I think it's very important to understand that you've already had multiple surgeries. And it is not unusual for someone with congenital ptosis to need multiple surgeries throughout their lifetime. So you may, because as far as that muscle changes, you know, as you age with continuous, a little bit of stretching, the lids will likely come down a little bit. It just varies from person to person. But as person gets older, they may need another surgery. So you may want to save that frontalis sling option for later. It doesn't mean that you can't repeat that surgery anyway, but just in the interest of minimizing the number of surgeries you have, you may want to just factor these variables that are less predictable and potentially can be problematic in terms of eye exposure, symmetry and aesthetics, and other issues that could occur. So you just have to have this discussion with your, most likely, your oculoplastic surgeon who performed this for you. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.